Hello. All right, let's see how this angle is. Not quite. Not quite. Give us just a moment. Perhaps. Thereabouts. Let's see. Did that change anything at all?
Mm-hmm.
There we go. All right. Well, I'm going to turn the light up a little bit because we're so far away. Mm-hmm. Welcome to Jazz Brunch. Thank you, Tacita, for the idea to make this a weekly live stream. Last week, I did sort of a ticketed live stream on my YouTube and got some great encouragement, so we've decided to make this a weekly affair while quarantine remains the norm. So you can meet us here Saturday mornings at 11 a.m. Central. Let's see. Oh, please feel free to share this link with any of your friends or family that you think would appreciate it. One of the biggest challenges facing independent musicians is just getting the word out, because some social media platforms like to kind of make it difficult to get the news out. Hi, Helen. And great segue. So first of all, if you would share this with people who might enjoy it, I would love that. Second of all, there is a chat feature. I don't actually know what it looks like as a viewer, but if you would like, take a second to locate the chat or comment function on your YouTube interface, because I'm going to try to make this a little bit more interactive and ask some questions between songs so that we can share our best practices for coping with quarantine. So, but now we're gonna play music. That's what you're here for. That's what I'm here for. And we're gonna start with a, not just one song, but a, okay. Not just one song, but it's a medley that I like to use to open a lot of my sets. So I'm starting with an original song called Island. So let's all imagine that instead of being stranded in our wonderful homes that we're so grateful for, imagine that you're on a beautiful beach somewhere, probably still with your family, but with a little more space to give each other. Anyway, here goes. Just a breeze of your breath, or a hint of your smile, and my senses ascend to some lonely isle, where my only care is the wind in your hair and the sound song on the waves. Let the birds do the picking and the weaving of the nest. Let my heart, let the sun rise, let its rays upon your chest. Let the ocean play the symphony that we like the most, and drift us into sleeping as it crashes on the coast. All the clouds have bowed their heads to shores. Let us dance where no feet have trod. So much for tuning in if you're already with us. This live stream will be available after the fact, so even if your friends are not available to watch right now, do feel free to share the link and they can view it at any time. Okay, so for my first crowdsource advice question, I would like to know about your favorite apps that are helping you survive quarantine. For example, the other night, oh, by the way, this is my husband Quentin, if you don't know him. Quentin's family got together on an app called House Party. So it's sort of like FaceTime, but you can add as many people as you want. And it has these little built-in games. So it's not just like you're staring at each other's faces like, so, how's everyone? You know, there's some built-in interaction there, and we're loving that. So think about it. Share in the chat what apps you're enjoying during quarantine that others might benefit from. And we're going to play this song in honor of how most of us are probably feeling right now.
Ooh.
I'm crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you. I love you. That's not crazy.
I love you.
All right, what's next? Okay, next question for the chat. I would love to know your recommendations for primarily movies, but maybe also TV shows that you have discovered during quarantine. So not necessarily just like your favorite movie in general, but is there anything new that you've discovered during quarantine? We watched Parasite the other night. It scared me. We watched Moneyball. Moneyball was good. We watched Limitless. We're really going back to 2011. Anyway, share your favorites in the chat, and hopefully we can help each other find some good stuff to watch in our downtime. Okay, now I like to mix it up a little bit. I do play a lot of jazz and originals, so I like to try and mix it up a little bit. So this one is Something by the Beatles. Question I have is for for families. It is for the benefit and discussion of families with children. I can't imagine how difficult it would be to guide young minds through something as confusing. I mean, I turned 29 in 1 month, and I am extremely confused and overwhelmed by the state of the world. So I can't imagine what it's like for kids. And I can't imagine what it's like for parents who are responsible for shepherding children through this. So, two things. Any wisdom or advice you have for how you're handling talking with your children about the world right now, but also more lighthearted, anything you've seen. So, for example, I've seen a few people post about bear hunts in their neighborhood, which is where a bunch of families will put a stuffed bear in their windows so that when families are out walking, they can play a game and, you know, spot the teddy bears in the neighborhood, which is super cute. And I know, like, some youth groups are doing drive-by challenges. And so anyway, any ideas you have for entertaining, getting creative with your kids or talking with them about confusing things. So I'm going to take a moment. During last week's live stream, I played my isolation love song, which was my, you know, weekly quarantine topical piece. This one is much shorter, but one of my favorite things that I do for work is writing children's music for an education company here in Nashville. And it's an honor, frankly, to write music that is intended to help kids navigate the world, even if it's something silly like teaching them about toys that require batteries. But there are also topics like bullying that I've gotten to write about. And anyway, so I decided to try my hand at a very short children's song about this moment. And so what I was picturing is we're all disappointed by plans that have fallen through. And I was picturing sort of like when you build a block or Lego tower and then your younger sibling comes in and like destroys it and you're like, hey, I worked so hard on that. But trying to reframe that moment of disappointment as an opportunity to build something new. So that's what this song is. When your plans fall apart, it may break your heart, but it's time to build something new. We can think, we can dream, we can work as a team, 'cause it's time to build something new. Imagine all the ways you can make the world better. Think of all the kindness you can share. You are brave, you are strong, and it won't be long till it's time to build something new. Very short, but perhaps something we can keep our eyes open for this week. Where are there opportunities to start new traditions with our family at home? Where are there, I mean, kids are so, their imaginations work better than ours. So maybe kids will have great ideas for how the world should be when we're able to get out there and do more things. So talk to your kids, gather some ideas. And okay, the next song we're gonna do, this is a slow one, but it's one of my favorites because really the most fun thing about playing music for me is the connection with other people. And this is a song that every time, I mean, almost every single time I've played it, it leads to a couple dancing, even if it's not a setting where dancing is the norm. So if you're at home with your honey, maybe this is a good time to do a little dance. Drifters off to see the world. you see the world? There's such a lot of world to see. Who participates in church or some sort of faith body, would love to hear about how your faith community is adapting to being pretty much entirely online. I know our church has been pretty active on Facebook. We're obviously live streaming services, as most of the country is, and trying to be really intentional about making phone calls and sending notes. So would love to hear what creative ways your church is handling the situation. If you are not a church person, I would love to hear about... Shoot, it just left my mind. Oh no. I'll remember it later, but go ahead, discuss in the comments. I'm going to pull up the next song. I'm not gonna play all of the breaks full length. Oh, where'd it go? But it should. So this song is, it's called La Camisa Negra by a Colombian rock star named Juanes. If you are not familiar with Juanes, I highly recommend his music. He's got lots of great stuff, including a couple duets with Nelly Furtado, which are bangers. So, again, this is pretty far outside of my jazz umbrella, but I love this song, so I play it anyway. So I hope you enjoy.
Te encontré por beberte. izquierdo hasta mi cama. Cama, cama, come on, baby. Te digo con disimulo que tengo la camisa negra y debajo tengo el difunto. Tengo la camisa negra porque negra tengo el alma. Yo por ti pedí la calma y casi pierdo hasta mi cama. Cama, cama, come on, baby. Te digo con disimulo.
Quarantine, also a great time to pick up new skills, like go on Duolingo and study Spanish. Like, my mom is killing it at Spanish. I'm currently working, I think I have a 276 or 7 day streak on Italian. Full disclosure, I did miss one day and have to do the streak repair, but 275 out of 276 days, I feel pretty good about that. And other languages open up new worlds, so it could be a great use of your time. Let's see, okay. So we're, I guess, just gonna do one more song. No, I skipped something. We're gonna do two more songs. So this is one of my favorite songs, and it's called I Wish You Love, and I just posted a video. I haven't put it on YouTube yet, because I'm uncertain about the legality, but we're gonna play I Wish You Love. So this video popped up really a while back, but it's had a recent resurgence. But there's a video of a little girl in China named Miu Miu playing guitar, and she's incredible. She's playing and singing this song, and she's 6 years old, and it's, her pitch is incredible, her rhythm is perfect. And I had so many people send me that video, both the first time it popped up and then recently, and I love it. And then a guitarist in Nashville did one of those split screen videos and added his own like fills and accompaniment to her original version. And I thought that was awesome. And then I saw a French drummer added to the guitarist video, and I was like, okay, I want in. So yesterday, in a rare burst of creative energy, I arranged some background parts for this song, and I posted the video. It's up on my Facebook, it's up on my Instagram, but maybe I'll put it up, that version, on YouTube. We'll see if it's allowed. Anyway, my version is slightly different from how she does it, but it's one of my favorite songs, so we're gonna play it for you. And this is also a good time to say that obviously, a lot of people, including musicians like ourselves, are experiencing a loss of work right now. And Quentin and I are really fortunate to have supportive families and to have savings. But it is a pretty big loss. So that's part of why we're doing this series. So if you feel led to tip, you can do so through Venmo, or if you feel uncomfortable with Venmo but you still want to give, you can contact me directly and we'll figure it out. But our Venmo username, I think, is in the description of this video, but it's @flower_power, flower power, because it's our name. But also, subscribing to me on YouTube is helpful, and sharing my videos with your friends, especially people outside of Nashville or other entertainment hubs. It's great to connect with people in other places. Anyway, here's a song, and we'll do it just twice through, and I'll do it. Breaking heart, and I agree.
de nos amours. Que reste-t-il de ces beaux jeux? Une photo, vieille photo de ma jeunesse. Que reste-t-il de billets doux, de mois d'avril, de rendez-vous en souvenir qui me poursuit sans cesse? Bonne fin d'année, je vous avance, pas de bonheur.
One more song for you. I do want to take this opportunity to promote myself. So I was talking with my parents on the phone, as I often and even more often do now, and they were giving suggestions of, you know, thinking outside the box of ways to make up for lost income. And it occurred to me that I feel like my biggest challenge is not so much the skill set that I have to offer or growing that skill set, but it's really just getting the word out, because a lot of social media platforms are sort of designed to suppress small businesses. I'm gonna close the door because you can hear our doorbell. There's just people working outside. Okay. So like Facebook wants you to pay to advertise your services. I do that some, but I don't want to get sucked into the paying rabbit hole. Anyway, something that is extremely helpful for me is for folks to share my videos, my channels, whatever, only with people who would really like it. I'm not asking you to, you know, send this to everyone you know, but if you know people that love old music or love jazz or love breathy vocals, I don't know, or quirky children's songs, please feel free to share my YouTube. Another way that you can be really helpful is signing up for my email list on my website. So my website is abigailflowersmusic.com, and I believe on the homepage there's a place to sign up for my email list. I have actually never sent out an email, but I feel like this is a good time to sort of start using that probably once every 2 weeks at most, just to let folks know about live streams or classes or whatever. Another thing that I would mention is that I love doing online lessons. So if you or your teenager is interested in learning ukulele or music theory, I would love to chat. I have one student who we have very consistent lessons, and we're mostly covering music theory, and it's so exciting to remember how hype I get about helping people understand music theory. So. Of course I sing. I don't feel like I'm a vocal instructor, like vocal technique, but I could definitely coach or help young people learn how to practice effectively. Anyway, so online lessons, email list, subscribe to YouTube. That's about it. Again, if you want to tip, you can do so through Venmo or get in touch with me directly if you are not comfortable with Venmo. Thank you to Quentin for playing. We're just gonna do one more. March is still Women's Month. We're almost done with it, but it's always Women's Month in my heart. So this song it's one of the most famous songs probably ever, but you might not know that the lyrics were written by a woman. Her name's Dorothy Fields, and I think that's one of the reasons I love these lyrics so much. Anyway, I hope you enjoy. And thank you for joining us this morning. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you guys so much for joining us this morning, and we'll see you same time next week.